In this example, we will use a synchronous modeling command to lengthen the arms of this model. Then, we will update the existing mesh to conform to the geometry changes. In situations where you do not have permission to modify the master CAD part, you can make the geometry changes to the CAE idealized part. First, load and display the idealized part. The master part is an assembly component of the idealized part. Before we can edit the CAD geometry in the idealized part, we must create an associative copy of the solid body from the master part. In the Advanced Simulation toolbar, click Promote. Select the solid body and then click OK. The promoted CAE model is now associated to the history in the master part. If the master part is updated, NX also updates the promoted body in the idealized part. Next, turn on the Synchronous Modeling toolbar. From the Synchronous Modeling toolbar, select Move Face. This command moves a set of faces, adjusting related faces accordingly. Click the Settings tab. The Face Finder automatically selects faces that are related to the faces that you select. It uses a set of search criteria to find the related faces. Turn on the Select Coaxial, select Go Planar, and select Symmetric Search Criteria. We will select faces that are normal to the desired move direction. Select one of the fillet faces, and an inner face of one of the holes. Because of the Select Coaxial option, the faces on the opposite arm that share the same axis were selected automatically. Select the large planar face. Use Quick Pick to select the planar face on the inside of the pocket. Because of the Select Go Planar option, the related planar faces on the opposite arm were also selected. Now we are ready to move the faces. Select the blue arrow handle, and drag it out to a distance of 50 mm. You can also type a value in the distance box. Click OK to accept the new distance. Suppose we want to make further adjustments to the arm length. Open the Part Navigator. A Move Face feature has been created in the model history. We can edit the feature and make further adjustments to the distance dimension. Right-click the feature and select Edit Parameters. In the distance box, change the value to 45 mm. Now that the geometry changes are finished, we can update the mesh. Select the Simulation Navigator. Display the FEM. The mesh is still based on the previous length of the arms. Use the update command to regenerate the mesh. After the update completes, the mesh once again conforms to the geometry. With synchronous modeling commands, the analyst can make changes to the design and then easily update an existing CAE model.